rest of the two sorting algorithms, that is merge sort and quick sort. Earlier we have discussed about insertion and selection, and now today we'll be discussing about the rest of the two algorithms. Cool. So first of all, I'll just give you a brief introduction about Newton School. Newton School is one of the good initiative taken up by some of the IIT grads, and it's all about making up the things easier for the people, those who are from those who are from other colleges where they didn't get much a more clean understanding of all the computer science fundamentals. Okay, so this is the Newton School website, and to just check with what's happening inside the program, you need to register yourself. Please register by filling up your details here. And once you have just registered, you can just log in. After logging in, you can just see all the things here inside the tracks section, where the more tracks will be for the full-time courses, and next with the Launchpad. Launchpad is also an initiative taken up by Newton School, where we are conducting a 10-day or 15-day courses for the most basic courses in the computer science. So you can load all the courses that you have inside the Launchpad. You can check everything here. And if you want to apply for any of the course, just click on apply button here. You need to fill up the application. And once you have just registered into this course, that track will be available here inside the track name. Okay, inside this, where there is a list of tracks are available here. You can just click on the course and you'll be able to see all the lectures that are present for that particular course. And you also have a doubt forum if there are any questions, and you can also add if you have any doubt, and those queries will be resolved within a minimum time. Okay, and here as well, in addition to this, we also provide one other thing called as a playground, where user can simply just click on any of this thing that is already created, or you can create one thing on your own, something like test one. You can just create your own IDE, and you can write your own code. You will having the complete integrated environment here inside the website. There is no need to use your any other local or any other online tool to perform. Okay. All right. So that's about a quick overview about Newton School. Cool. So next we will be coming into the topics. It's about so earlier, until this point, we have discussed something like what are linked lists, what are arrays, and what are the use of both of the data structures, and next with what different kind of sorting algorithms. One we discussed is already the selection sort. The other one is the insertion sort. So, and today we'll be discussing about merge sort and quick sort. Okay, cool. So those who haven't watched about the sorting algorithms basic video, that is the previous video that we have discussed, please watch that, and then this will be the continuation for that, the same video. So right, we have several algorithms when talking about the sorting. So one today we are discussing is about merge sort. The name itself something suggests like, okay, merge sort. So first we need to sort the elements and then we need to merge, right? The name itself sounds a little bit familiar. Okay, we will see step by step what the algorithm will be. So merge sort generally deals with dividing that particular array that is given for you into two halves and recursively sorting each half. Okay, dividing, first of all, whatever the input that is given, we will be dividing that array into two halves and recursively sorting the each half. And once you sort them, you are going to again merge them. All right. These are the simple three basic steps that we follow when you are talking about merge sort. Okay. We will just mentioned that these are the points that we are having when we are dealing with merge sort. We will simply see how it will work with a real-time example. Okay. So for suppose, consider this as an array. This is array 10 or something like, you will take Okay, so the element we have is 8, sorry, 9, 8, 1, 4, and 5. All right. So what merge sort will do is, first of all, merge sort will divide the array into two halves. Two halves, which are equally divided. So if you divide the 5-element array, one side will be 3 and the other side will be 2. Okay. So when the element is divided, it will be 9, it will be 8, and this one will be 1. All right. So these elements will be 4 and 5. Next, again, it will divide recursively until the point where you can't divide that array. Okay. When you can divide the array into much further, when you have a single element, right? So you have an array of 9, 8, 1. If you divide them again, you will get 9 and 8. You have 1. Again, here it will divide it as 9, and here you have the element as 8. Cool. So at this particular step, where further it could not divide the elements into the further thing, it can't divide the single element into half, right? So at this step, it will stop the recursion and it will return back from here. So what it need to do, it will merge from here. How it is going to merge? It will simply check. So the if you see, this is once sorted subarray, and this is also a sorted subarray. If you have a single element, it is already sorted, right? So comparing these two elements, we will keep an auxiliary array here and we will sort them here itself. It means we are merging two sorted arrays, okay? So 9 and 8, we will compare. So 8 will be coming up here and 9 will be coming up here. And this particular thing will be overridden, okay? So you can just strike it off here. All right. So at this, so this step is done now. The next thing is now you have 8 and 9, you have 1 here. And it will, as a recursion, it will backtrack to the next step, right? And at this part, again, it will check. It will have two pointers because you have one is for the left subarray, the other one is for the right subarray, and it will check whether which one is. We will just compare two arrays, and based on the two sorted arrays, we will arrange all the sorted elements in a resultant array. It is nothing but our original array, okay, using a extra auxiliary array. So we'll compare 8 and 1. 1 is lesser, 1 will be done here, and no other elements were there inside this particular array. Now 8 and 9, 8 will be sorted, 8 will be mentioned here, and next 9 will be mentioned here. All right. So now again, this array is modified using that. The original array is modified. All right. Next, again, so we have 1, 8, 9, you have 4, 5 here. For the next iteration, it will create an auxiliary array, which is already created, and you have the length of 5 now. And inside this, you will have two pointers. The first pointer will be comparing about 1 and 4. 1 is lesser, 1 will be here. As one element is inserted, we need to increment that pointer, right? Next, the pointer will be here, 8 and 4. 4 is lesser. 4 will be given here. This pointer need to be incremented now. Now compare with 5 and 8. 5 is lesser. 5 will be inserted. Next, the pointer will be increased as it is greater than the array length. Now it won't again come here. It will check with, the pointer is at 8 itself. You will check. Now the 8 will be inserted here. And pointer increment, 9 inserted. That's all. We are at the end of the array. So at last, the array will be sorted. Simple. The it's more of dividing the array until the point where you can't divide it much further, and recursively sorting that particular array. We are using a recursion, right? At every step, we are backtracking the thing, and once it is sorted, we are just merging those two subarrays. How we are going to merge? Merge is a simple thing. If you have two sorted arrays, how you can merge? You'll just have the resultant length where you need the resultant array where you need to store these two sorted arrays. That array length will be sorted array one length plus sorted array two length, right? That would be the resultant array. So we'll just put a two pointers, one pointer for array one, the other pointer for the array two. We will compare both the values, which is lesser, that will be inserted into the resultant array. Simple. All right. Great. So now shall we write starting the shall we start writing the code for the same? Yeah, we already have selection and insertion here. Okay, I don't want to disturb this thing. I'll just copy up the simple main class here, and so the language that I want will be Java. All right, this is the main class. Just ignore this thing for now. So we are taking up the elements as this 10, 8, 1, 6, 9, and now for the sorting class, we need to. Okay, I'll be start writing the code for. Okay, I'll just. Class sorting. Inside that, I am writing first to sort the array using merge sort. So integer array. So when we are discussing about merge sort in the practical implementation, we talked that we need an extra array to store it, because see, when you are merging up two arrays, when you are comparing two sorted arrays and to store the result in another array, better to have a copy of an auxiliary co copy of a copy of that array that we are dealing, so that it would be easy for us to maintain the result as well. So I'm creating an auxiliary array which is of length array dot length, right? The auxiliary array will also be the same, the copy of the array that we are dealing with. All right, so I am using a helper method which is sort. Inside this, I am sending our own array, auxiliary array. Now I'm sending 0, which is the starting index of our array, and also array dot length minus 1, which is the highest index better I'll write a whole merge sort inside a single class to avoid the confusion. Okay, all right. So now inside this public void sort. The reason why I am writing another helper method is, as we discussed, that we need to recursively sort the each half, right? So for that reason, I am writing another helper method. Have taken two of original array and auxiliary array. The next element will be low, the next one will be high. Simple. I'm just maintaining the values as high and low so that it would be easy for us to get an idea when we are dealing. Okay, so when this recursion will be stopped? Once the low and high crosses their cells, right? So low will be always at the starting index and high will be at the ending index. Once these two pointers come across, then we need to stop, right? Something like high is less than or equal to low, then you need to simply return that. Okay, simple. Nice. So what we need, how we are going to sort the elements, how we are going to divide them? It is simply every time we are dividing the element into half, right? So array, auxiliary array, low value, and every time we need to calculate the mid. So mid can be calculated in two ways. The something like low plus high divided by two, or sometimes we can also calculate by low plus high minus low divided by two. You can do either ways, but most of the mathematical people always think that this is the best way to solve, best way to get the mid value all the time, and it gives the appropriate ones when you have the larger size of array as well. Okay, low and now mid. Until the mid, that can be in one place, and array, auxiliary array. Mid is already there inside the left side of the array, and now mid plus from mid plus one to high. All right. So what are we doing? We are just recursively calling up the function to divide the array into half. Every time we are going to divide the array into its half, right? So as we discuss this particular thing, first it is divided into 3, 2, next it's divided into 2, 1, 1, 1. So in that way, we are going to divide the array first. All right. So once it is divided, next, what is the step that we need to make? Because as it is divided and the sort is happening, we need to also check with the we need to also do another step, which is called as merging them. So merge arr, x, low, mid, and high. All right. So because when we are merging, we are going to provide the low value, mid value, and also high value, because we need the two pointers to be maintained, right? All right. So merge integer arr int array a auxiliary int low int mid int high. Right. So at the point of merging, what all we can do? So as we discussed that we need to have the two arrays which are already sorted, and using those two arrays, and also using one auxiliary array, we can just simply put up two pointers and make the resultant sorted array into the original array, right? With the help of these two, we can simply make those things work and make them make the sorted array to be inside the original array itself. So for that reason, what we need to do, it is something like int k equal to low, until which value it need to iterate, until the high, it is the last index, right? So what are we doing? We are just copying the original array into auxiliary array. Simple. So original array is AR and auxiliary array is AUX. Right. So the array is copied now. Next, what we are going to do? Once the array is copied into an auxiliary array, we will put two pointers, right? So low will be copied with I value. Now J will be copied with J need to be the mid value is pointed, so I'm making it as mid plus one. So and so again, now until which point it need to be iterated, it where k starts with low and k ends with k less than or equal to high and k plus plus. So using this iteration, what we need to check whether array of I, whether array of I less than array of j. if area of I is less than area of j, what we need to do? We need to simply put array of k equal to auxiliary space of I, and we need to put I value there, and we also need to post increment that particular value. Else, if array of I is not less than that particular value, what we are going to do, we need to put the other way around. It is something like aux of j plus plus, because I will be at the first index, first sorted array index, and j will be the pointer for the second sorted array, right? And here we also have a corner case where if the pointer is moving out of the length for the array, for the sorted array. So that is the reason we are adding up some conditions here, where if I is greater than mid. So if I is greater than mid, it means that the left side array is done. Left sorted array is done. We need to increment for the right sorted array. So array of k equal to aux of j plus plus. And the same thing for right side array as well. If j is greater than high, area of k equal to, then we need to enter the left side elements. If both are already done, then like it won't even enter into any of the conditions, and it will just come out. Okay, so to discuss this merge method again, we are just first of all copying up the elements. Copy elements into aux, because we have just created here, the auxiliary array is created, but we didn't copy anything until this point. So we will just copy all the elements that we have inside the original elements, and we are creating two pointers. One is for the left side subarray, and the other one is for the right side subarray. If left is sorted, then you need to increment the pointer. You need to copy remaining elements in the right side array. If right is sorted already, pointer is moved, it means that, yeah. So this is the exact, this is a basic comparison that we are making between left array and compare left element with right element. Okay, and based on the comparison, if which is a lesser value, that will be going on to the original array, right? So if I is lesser, that array of I is lesser, then that will be done. And if it is not less, then definitely the j will be the lesser element, right? So next j will be inserted. So this is the simple way of implementing the merge sort, where you're just dealing with dividing the element recursively, and then adding up the, like, you're just copying up this all the values into an auxiliary array, then merging up them based on the values that you have in the left and right sorted arrays. Okay, so obj dot merge sort of that array, and you need to get this output. So let's run and see what is happening here. We got some error, okay, some semicolons. Yeah, it happens most of the time in Java when we are dealing. We need to put up semicolons here inside this statement as well. Run. Okay, I need to import arrays. Import java.util.arrays. If you see up to some part it is sorted, and at particular value it is not being sorted. So we need to check where we are missing out some condition and adding up the things. Yeah. So when mid value is correct, it is nothing wrong with the mid value. Sort at the sort we are showing up the values as we are sending up low and mid, and next mid plus one and high we are sending up the value. So comparing the element here as well. So we are just dealing the merge. We are calling the merge here, array and auxiliary array. Low and mid is sent here as a high value, and the array is taken up here. The auxiliary array is copied. The elements are copied into auxiliary array. I will be always low and j will be mid plus one when I is greater than mid. When I value is greater than mid, we are going to copy j values. When j is greater than high, then we are copying up these values. So array of j is less than array of I, then I need to copy the j elements, else we can copy the I elements. We can do either ways. High and low are at the same level. This should not be. This is the breaking condition that we are making, right? So. Still the same. So. When we add something as mid plus one here. No, here we need to pass mid as well. Low plus high minus low by two is this thing. So it's not comparing the last element. So there is some issue with the second sorted element that we're dealing with. I guess we just missed out some condition that we need to follow. We will trace one by one point. So taking up the mid element, that is the sort will be taking up the mid element, that is proper, and the low and the mid value, mid plus one, and next with the high value, this is how the sort recursively calls. And mid plus one and high, we are calling it in a proper fashion. Nothing wrong with it. K is less than or equal to. So we have this only to change up the values. There is something like the k will be that the original array will be copied onto the auxiliary array, and we are maintaining two pointers where I will be the low value all the time, and j will be the mid plus one pointer. So it means that if you have two sorted arrays, one will be pointing at I, the other one will be pointing at j. All right. The next thing is, whenever the mid is calculated, the array of first time we will check whether the left pointer is completed or not. Now the j will be moved. Next, j will be calculated. J is greater than I or not. The I values will be done. Next, array of j is less than the array of j. Simple mistake that we made here when we are writing up. This is something like, so as we have copied everything onto auxiliary array, the comparison that we need to make also need to be from the auxiliary array, right? It should not be from the original array, because we are storing up the values in the original array, right? So my bad here. When we are comparing, you should not compare with the original array, because we have copied everything onto the auxiliary, because for the reason for to be in the comparison table. I have compared using the array, the original array. You should not do that, because the resultant will be stored into the original array. The comparison will be made using the auxiliary array. We just made a minor mistake here. No issues. So this is how the whole sort works, the merge sort thing, and where we are using the helper method, which will divide the array into half every time and recursively sort all the elements, and it will merge in this way. In the merge also, there is nothing wrong here. We are just maintaining two pointers, and each will compare with the left subarray and right subarray, and which are already sorted, and it will merge based on the values that which are lesser. The lesser value will be put first into the resultant array. All right. Cool. So this is how merge sort works. And so what could be the time complexity for the merge sort? So as you have seen already, when you're dividing that array in half every time recursively. So every time it is something like n by 2, n by 4, n by, and so on. It is something like a log n, right? This thing we already discussed. All right. So log n times, it will divide everything. And how many times it is going, this log n will happen? It will happen for each and every element that we have. So it is something like n log n. So n log n is the time complexity that we have to merge sort. And when coming to the space complexity thing, this is the sorting algorithm where we use the other auxiliary array, which we are going to use for making up the so the resultant array that we are making up sorted will be an original array, and auxiliary array is there to make those things, makes those comparisons work. All right. So this is how the merge sort thing works. This is not in place. It means that we are using an extra auxiliary space. It is something like if you have something like a million items of a million elements of million items inside an array, you will be again using other million length array to make it as an auxiliary space, and then we will make our merge sort to work. So that is how merge sort works. All right. Cool. So that is the next kind of sorting algorithm that we have is called as a quick sort. Okay. Until this point, we have discussed about merge sort. Now we will discuss about the quick sort. Super. Now the quick sort is a kind of a similar one, but it is not. There we have used the auxiliary space, but here we won't use any auxiliary space. The only thing that we do is simply we will make one random element as a pivot element or a pivot element, okay, or a partitioning element. We call it as a partitioning element for a simplicity. So always that partitioning element, default, we will take it as the first element that is there in the array. Okay. The first step that we do is in an array, we will take the first element as a pivot element. Okay. By taking up that particular value as pivot or partitioning element, what are we going to do? Simple. All the elements which are lesser than that particular element, that particular pivot element, will be on the left hand side. All the elements which are on the right hand side will be always in a greater, which are the all are greater. Okay. So taking an assumption or initializing a particular element, random element or a default as a first index element, zeroth index element, that element is taken as a partitioning element. And rest of the elements which are there in the array, the lesser elements will be on the left hand side and greater elements will be on the right hand side. Okay. That the reason we are calling it as a partition is something like this particular element will partition the whole array, saying that all the left hand elements, all the left side elements will be lesser than me and all the elements on the right will be greater than me. Okay, so the partition is done. The left side array will be, all the lesser elements will be on one side and all the greater elements on the other side. Then we will recursively sort and at last it will be this particular, the partitioning will be done recursively every time inside subarray, and then you will get the necessary sorted array at last. We will see the working example for this as well. Just a second, I'm just removing everything. Yeah, so how are we going to do in this? This is the array that we have. And so we are saying that we have the pivot element. So in this case, 9 is the partitioning or the pivot element. All right. And we are making up two pointers. One is at the first index, the other one is at the last index. So, right, what are we guaranteeing here? We are going to guarantee that all the elements which are lesser will be on the left hand side. All the elements which are greater will be on the right hand side. So if you want much clarity, we will just maintain another element here as 10, because there should be at least one element to understand for the simplicity purpose. So 9, 8, 10, 4, 5. All right, so cool. So what we need to check first, we need to check, is there any element which is which are all the lesser elements need to be made by this pointer and greater elements need to be pointed by this pointer. Super. So first we are checking for the lesser element. 8 is a lesser element, no issues, increment. Next, 10 is a greater element, so we are not going to move forward in this direction. Okay. Cool. Now the I pointer will be stopped at this particular location. Okay. This is the P element. P will be constant throughout the array at this iteration. Right. So now the J pointer is at this place where it is indicating the last value, 5. 5 is a lesser value than 9. So it will be stopping at here, at this point itself, because the J pointer always need to indicate the greater elements and I pointer need to indicate the lesser elements. So at this particular stage, we got into a point where I is having the greater element than 9 and J is having the lesser element than 9. So we need to simply swap these two elements. Okay. After swapping, what we will be getting? 9, 8, 5, 4, and 10. So as this particular index is sorted, then we need to decrement the J value. And as this is sorted, we need to increment I value. All right. So the pivot will be constant all the time. So now I and J are at the same position. We will, when I and J are at the same position, we need to, it is a breaking point, and we will just simply swap the elements with this particular element. So 4, 8, 5, 9, and 10. Simple. So by this, at this step, it is something like all the elements are lesser than pivot on the left hand side, all the elements which are greater are on the right hand side. Again, the same thing applies. We will just partition the array based on this subarray. So this will be this 4, 8, 5 will be on one subarray, and this 9 will be another subarray, because 10 will be another subarray, because here it is something like the, when you are making a partition at first step, it will make that pivot element to be placed in a proper position in a resultant array. Okay, it seems like it will be in a position where it will be in a place where it won't be changed again, right? Because nine will be having a fixed place, because all the lesser elements will be on one side and the greater elements will be on the other side. And then we will just sort the left and right. Again, from here, you will take the pivot element, you will put the I and J pointers where a less than pivot element need to be on one side and greater than pivot need to be on another side. Once the pivot is placed, again, we will take up the remaining subarray into different, taking up a pivot element, putting up I pointer, J pointer, merging them, changing the positions based on the lesser and greater values. So this is about the quicksort. It's a basic, implementation of quicksort. And when you're dealing with quicksort, the best case will be the same as n log n, like how we had in the merge sort. But the only thing is, in worst case, when it is already sorted, then the array might take nearly n square by two comparisons, because every time it need to check throughout each and every element, even if it is sorted. So that is the worst case case scenario where the quicksort will make much comparisons. But the only thing is, it is an in place algorithm where we are not using any kind of auxiliary space, and it could be a simple implementation of quicksort when it is one of the most important algorithms in the present world. And so if you compare the algorithms like selection sort, insertion sort, quick and merge sort, if you deal with insertion sort for a billion entries, it might take years to sort those elements. But when compared to merge sort, it might take maybe something like a half an hour to compute that billion elements. And then coming to the quicksort, it will do that within 15 minutes of time. But if you want to do it, there are some improvements, something like before making choosing a pivot element, better to shuffle the whole input array that you're getting, so that even if the array is sorted, it won't go to the worst case. If it is randomly sorted, then it will be a best case, and it will do it in the n log n time. And generally inside Java as well, they use merge and quicksort. If you want to sort the objects, then they use merge sort. And for the primitive data type sort, I hope you all know what are primitive data types, something like int, long, float, and double. If you want to make the sorting for those primitive data types, then they use quicksort inside the Java implementation. Yeah. So that is about the merge and quicksort. The next thing could be something like we can implement the quicksort as well by coming here. So we have the class merge sort here. I am writing the class quicksort inside this void quicksort int and array. Simple. We are taking up the So we are taking an element we are taking up a class quicksort, which will have a method quicksort. Inside there, it will take the input as an array, and we will have a help method here as well, where it need to call array 0, which is the starting index, and 1, which is the ending index. Simple. And here, void sort of int array int low int high. Simple. We are just making the pointers low and high. Okay. Then what is the condition to, what will be the condition for to break the recursion? It is something like when I and j, both the pointers low and high, both the pointers were sorted, like were crossing, were come across each other, then you need to break the recursion. Something like return, or base, we call it as a base condition, right? Condition inside recursion. All right, so what we are dealing here inside this, we need to first get the partition element. We need to first of all partition the array, partition of array comma low comma high. Simple. We will see what we need to do after getting this partition done. Partition. Okay. Next, the method that we need to implement is, we need to return a partition element, right? Where it is partitioned, and array and low and high. All right. So after getting this partition, we need to after writing this is a method signature for partition thing. And inside that, we need to maintain two pointers. We need to check how the thing is happening with the pointers, right? So int I equal to low, that is the first index, and int j equal to high plus 1. Because I'll be decrementing and incrementing the values in the pre-order itself. So I'm making a simple which while the while loop which will enter all the run all the time, but we will keep a break condition inside where if that particular I pointer will be crossing up the j, this will be the breaking condition for the loop. Okay, but before that we would like to do what all we will check? We will check whether array of I is less than array of low. Until it is low, it won't do anything. If I equal to high, just break. Okay, because that is the highest index that we have. But every time when you're doing this, just pre-increment the I value so that it would be easy for us to do it. You can do the same thing inside this as well, but I'm just reducing the number of lines of code, or I'm just putting up here itself because it will pre-increment the value. Okay, increment the I value, then it will check. Okay, while array of, now the low value, low always the low value will be having the pivot element that we have, so it will check always. We have compared for the lesser elements, and the next time it will be for greater elements. Okay, array of low need to be, if array of low is less than area of J, which is minus minus simple, until that low value is less than that particular, the left side element, the right side elements, you can change. But if J equal to low at any point, you need to break the condition. All right. So if you check that at one point, these two will be breaking, these two loops will be breaking at some particular index, and that will be definitely a like swapping condition, right? So swap of ARR comma I comma J, simple. And outside here, we need to swap with ARR comma low comma J, because always low will be storing up the first pivot element, and J will be something like J and I were crossed at particular point, and we need to swap that J pointer with low, or you can also swap with I pointer with low, nothing wrong in it. So now we will return J because we have just swapped that with the value with the pivot element, right? That will be the partitioning value. So we need to write swap as well, swap and ARR int I comma int J, and how we are going to swap the elements, and temp equal to ARR of I, area of I equal to area of J, area of J equal to temp. Simple. We are just swapping up the elements here, and this is for the lesser values, and this is for the greater values. And if I is greater than or equal to J, we will break this, because these two pointers are coming across. This is the break condition. Break condition. And next we are, if the I and J stuck at one particular point, then we are going to swap that particular indexes, because this is the swapping condition where we met an element which is greater than the left side, and we met an element that is lesser on the right side. We need to swap those both elements. Okay. And at the end, if the this while loop will be break, and here we are swapping up the right pointer with the low value, so that the pivot element will be at the exact place where it need to be, and we are just returning up the J value so that it will return the index that we want. Okay. Once we got that J value, we need to simply, now we got the J, so J is fixed now, J minus value need to be given, and the same with for the next half. So J, the left subarray, we are going to call again J with the right subarray. Simple. All right. So let's call the merge sort function. Control Z. Quick sort. Yeah. So if you see, this is just a helper method. See, this sort is an helper method to call the recursion. This is the breaking condition. This is the base condition where high and lower crossing each other. Then we will return. We will first call the partition method, which will partition the elements, and it will make the lesser elements on one side and the greater elements on the other side. And then we will recursively call the sort function so that it would be recursively doing for the whole array. Super. Cool. So we will just take the same input we have, and we will run the output. Yeah. So it is running in a good way, and it is giving us values. All right. So this is all about the quicksort implementation as well, where without using any auxiliary space or without using any extra space, we have did this thing. We have achieved the sorting without using any extra space, but in Merge we are using an extra space where it will deal with keeping up an auxiliary array and measuring both the values. That sense. Okay, so this is all about merge sort and quick sort, and you can have an analysis based on all the sorting things that we have discussed until this point. We have discussed selection, we have discussed insertion, we have discussed merge, and we have discussed quick, right? These four, just make a comparison, take up an array of length 50,000 elements or 50 million elements and check the time that is taking using Java stopwatch or Java timer that we have inside Java predefined in the library, and use those built-in libraries and check how much time it is taking, compare it, and if you are increasing the input, what is the time it is, how in what ratio the time is getting increased. So you will have a better idea when you analyze on your own, and that's all for today. Thank you all.